Papa's got a brand new bag.
All right, Olson U, hope everyone's doing fantastic. For the next episode of the Mr. Santa's Cooking Show, we did a poll recently, and you asked, and we listened. And so we're going to be making, especially for you, a zucchini sauerkraut pie. And we're very excited about this. And I've got, to do that, we're going to make our own crust. I've got 2.5 cups of flour right here. I've got 2 sticks of butter. And let me show you how I process this butter here. You might have to zoom in a little bit. But all I'm doing is I'm going to, the thing is you want to have this butter cold, and you want to have it diced up pretty well. So what I do is I tend to make each stick into 4 other sticks, just like that. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cross cut it and add that to my flour mix. Once I've got all the butter in my bowl here, what I'm going to do is basically toss the butter in the flour. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to work the butter in the flour just by squeezing each little cube into the flour. So I want each cube kind of flattened out. I just squeeze it between my finger and thumb, and I just keep moving it. I'm continuing to toss it. And what that's gonna do, that's really gonna help us make that flaky crust that I know everyone, especially when you have a zucchini sauerkraut pie like the one we're making today. Oh yeah, you're gonna want that flakiness. You also really wanna try to move fast, because you don't want the butter to really melt at all. You want it to stay cold. All right, so we've got our mixture well incorporated with the butter. What I'm gonna do now is I'm going to add about 5, maybe 6 tablespoons of ice water. Is that 5 or 6? I don't know. Put 5.5. Now I like to use my hands. The reason why I'm using ice water once again is to keep that butter from really melting too much. And I'm just gonna work that whole thing into a kind of a dough mixture. It'll come together really quickly here, as you can see. All right, so I've got my 2 doughs here. I'm gonna put these in the fridge for, I don't know, about 30 minutes or so. I get to take a break, and when we come back, I'm gonna show you how I process our zucchini and get that ready with our sauerkraut to put together our pie. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a blind bake with this thing. We're gonna blind bake it, and you'll see what that means. And I think we've done that maybe on other shows in the past, but yeah, we'll go forward from there. Stick with us. All right, so we're doing another zucchini recipe, obviously. Kind of funny. We can compost this. But instead of using a grater, what we're gonna use this time is a mandolin, which is a wonderful tool that can really speed things up. It can be pretty dangerous, so when you get a little bit closer, I really want to encourage everyone to use the guard here. But when it, on an application like this, it gets, it's really hard to do that. So just watch. Okay, so I've processed my zucchini. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna saute it. Sauteing is a, well, it's a French term, but basically it's not a French technique. I mean, because basically what we're doing is we're lightly cooking it in oil. But what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna get my pan going. I'm gonna saute the zucchini first before I add sauerkraut and or anything else to the pie. So stick with us as I do this. I've lightly salted this, tossed it. Now I'm just gonna toss this with oil. I'm cooking this in olive oil. All right, and as you can see, we've got our zucchini here is well on its way to being completely sauteed. I'm gonna kill the heat and let it sit for a second while we put together some herbs and spices for the pie. Stick with us. All right, what I am doing now is I am rolling out my pie crust because we are gonna do what they call in the business. They call this a blind bake. And what's going on is, you know, this crust is gonna be holding in a delicious zucchini and sauerkraut pie filling. And so it's gonna be hard. It's a thermodynamic nightmare anytime we're making a pie, right? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna help each other out, help this pie out by doing what we call a blind bake. And a blind bake is, we're gonna put in, you can go to the store and buy pie weights, but for hundreds and hundreds of years, what a lot of us have been doing is using dried beans. And what we're gonna do that today, I'll show you that process. So what I'm doing right now is I'm gonna fit my, you can see I need a little bit bigger here. I'm rolling out my pie crust to hit the, it's got the right size, and then I'll put it in the shell here and fill it with my pie weights, and then we'll bake it probably for about 30 minutes or so at 375 degrees Fahrenheit, and we'll have the conversion for Celsius right down low here. But one of the things I did that I know. Was a weak point of mine when I went into the summer months here. I knew going into it that I wasn't about to enter the fall and winter season not knowing how to make these crusts. So I spent, you know, a lot of time right here working on my pie recipe. I know you've probably seen some of the earlier episodes of the Mr. Snap's Cooking Show. Didn't I make a quiche episode once? I thought I made a quiche episode once. Anyhow, you know, I wasn't good at it, but we all know, just like, you know, with reading, with mathematics, we're always trying to get better at all the stuff we're doing. And so practice makes perfect. And that's what happened with this. So I'm by no means a master baker. I'm not gonna get on that TV show. Master Chef? No. The Great Baking Competition.
Great British Bake Off.
The Great British Bake Off. I'm not gonna get on that show with this. But you know what? I could hold my own at the Minnesota State Fair if they put me down to it. Yeah, if they wanted to put the Mr. Snap's Cooking Show down at the fair next year, which we've been applying to now for 2 years and have been completely snubbed by the State Fair Association, and that's fine. You know, it's a process. It's not an overnight situation. I understand that. Yeah, so that's the deal. And you can see here that I'm just kind of, you know, making a pie. It's not rocket. It's not like a rocket. You know, it's not gonna take off. Or basically, what I'm saying is, it's you don't have to be perfect to do this, and it doesn't help to be really good at it. It does help to be really good at it, but you know, like I said, this is what it looks like right there. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna find my pie weights, and I just keep them in a little container like this. I keep them in tin foil. You can see here. I think these are black beans that, you know, we've used here at this house. We use these. You know, seems like we make a lot of crusts around here. You probably use these once a week at least. And I just fold that out just like that. And what that does is, because this is such a flaky crust, it's gonna weigh it down a little bit so it doesn't poof up, which is the science behind it, right? And so now I got my oven here. I'm gonna pop this in the oven for about 30 or so minutes, and then I can put my filling in there. You're probably wondering, what about this one, Mr. Snaps? We're gonna, because this is gonna be on top of the pie, and there's a lot of heat's gonna be able to get to it, we're gonna let this one, you know, go. The other thing that we gotta work on right now is our filling. So you can see here, we've got the zucchini here. I made a delicious batch of sauerkraut over the summer. I made a few batches, actually. We don't have a lot left, but thankfully we had some left for this episode. What I'm gonna do here, just a wonderful, wonderful smell. I'm gonna add a couple hefty spoonfuls of sauerkraut. Love it. Sauerkraut is such a wonderful thing and healthy for you. It's fermented cabbage. And I highly recommend, if you can make sauerkraut, I think one of our very first episodes of the show was making sauerkraut. I think episode 4, I want to say. A lot of great bacteria. A lot of people talk about yogurts, probiotics. This is all the stuff that's present right here in sauerkraut. So this is homemade, delicious. It's got a wonderful flavor. And it's a great gift. It's a wonderful gift to give to people. And there's nothing like opening up a present and it's a jar of sauerkraut. With Christmas rolling around the corner, if anyone wants to get me anything, kidding. No, but seriously, it's a great gift. And so we're gonna put this in there. And we're gonna put a little bit more salt. And we're gonna cut the camera here. And I'm gonna show you, we have a couple dried herbs I'm gonna add in there as well. All right, so I'm gonna add a little bit of some dried oregano. I'm gonna add a little bit of a little dried basil. I was gonna add some, we had a little herb garden growing this stuff over the summer. We're actually all out, so. That's why you have to go to store-bought. But we're gonna add this to our pie. So we're gonna let this sit here. Let's give it a quick taste here. Wonderful. We're gonna let that sit. We're gonna let our pie bake for another 26 or so minutes. Then I'm gonna fill it and roll out the other one, the top half, and bake it till it's done. And we're gonna have a delicious zucchini sauerkraut pie to enjoy. So stick with us. With this extra time, it's a wonderful time to crack open a book, enjoy that. Thank you very much. All right, so my timer just went off. I'm gonna pull my pie crust. Cool off a little bit, and I'll put them right back in there. But you can see, this is our finished product here, or not really finished, but it's our, you know, halfway done product, I should say. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna fill this pie with my filling. All right, so the other pie crust is right here, and roll that out. Now, I understand that Julia Child would probably not approve of this guy because it's too small. She would call this a toy, but that's all I got, so I work with it. See if this is big enough. And yeah, that's big enough. This thing is still very hot. I'll show you one quick thing. This is called a pie bird, okay? This is called a pie bird. And what this is, as you can see, you can kind of see through it. It's a vent, actually. So traditionally, this would be placed inside the pie, underneath the crust and out, so a gas could escape through the beak of the bird. That's called a pie bird, traditional. But oftentimes what is really used is simply a tin foil, and in this case we're gonna cut some slots in the pie. I might have fun with it here. I might kind of make a decoration. Who knows? Okay, I took the extra crust and I kind of made a ring and placed it around there. I should have scored that, and we'll talk about that in another episode. And I did cut some vent holes with a paring knife. The reason I did that is because if you think back to, I'm not sure if we've talked about in science class, Charles' Law, volume of a gas is proportional to its temperature. And it's gonna get pretty warm in that oven. It's at 375 degrees Fahrenheit. And so I don't want my pie to explode. And so I've cut some vent holes to prevent that from happening. I always think of Charles Law's CTV, cable TV, is how I remember what two variables we're working with Charles Law. I also remember you could also, for Boyle's Law, it's volume and pressure, Vice President Biden. Or when I learned that little thing back, this is 20 years ago when Biden was the vice president. Now, I would have to use a very, I'll think of a Boyle's Law mnemonic device for you. Yeah, so I'm probably gonna bake it for 30 or 40 minutes. And, but I'm gonna wait a couple minutes before I put it in the oven. My oven's at 375 degrees Fahrenheit, like I previously stated. Stick with us. All right, it's been about 30 or so minutes. Let's see what we have here. I'm thinking what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let it go for about another, 5 or 10 minutes. So we'll see you in about 5 or 10. All right, it's been another 10 minutes or so, and I'm thinking we're gonna take this guy out of the oven. Oh yeah, looking delicious. Oh yeah. Yeah, so looking great. We're gonna let that cool. I'll come back and we'll show you what it looks like when we cut into it. But yeah, thanks for sticking with us so far, and yeah. All right, so we're gonna cut into our little creation. Is this sucker smelling good? Oof. Oh yeah, so I'll just take a look here. Now I'll just take a quick bite here. Tell you what, that is the best gosh darn zucchini sauerkraut pie that I've ever tasted. I hope you can follow along at home with our recipe, and I hope you get to make one for yourself. It's a great way to celebrate fall and celebrate, you know, life in general. So bon appetit and happy cooking, and we'll see you next time on the Mr. Snaps Cooking Show. Thank you. Back to the pie though. I'm gonna wait about, I don't want to eat this. I'm gonna probably bake it for about 30 or 40 more minutes, and then I'll probably